McCallum, who's died at the age of 90. Okay, let's take a look at the weather with Judith. I'm not sure I saw those blue skies in Glasgow today.
They were there. I missed them. Talking about that being the athlete's village during the Commonwealth Games.
Yeah,
we did see some blue sky, something from the inner city for a change. Yeah. Thank you very much, Laura. A wee bit of blue sky there behind me to cheer us up before Storm Agnes reaches our shores tomorrow. But as far as this evening and tonight's concerned, it's fairly quiet actually. Still a scattering of showers around initially, but they tend to ease as we head through the overnight period into clear spells, maybe the odd mist patch in there. Just the odd shower grazing the Western Isles, the North West and the Northern Isles, both in ease down as well. Temperature wise, could be down as low as 4 or 5 Celsius, a few parts of Grampian, but generally around about 8 or 9 degrees. So into tomorrow, well, Storm Agnes, the first named storm from the Met Office, is crossing our shores tomorrow, bringing a swathe of heavy rain and high winds as well. So inevitably, there are a couple of warnings in force. Firstly, a high wind warning pretty much countrywide, potential gusts of 50 miles per hour through the central lowlands at times, and down towards the southwest is where we'll probably see the strongest winds, gusts of 60 to 70 miles per hour expected here. Then we have a heavy rain warning for parts of western Scotland, from the southwest into towards Argyll, Stirlingshire and the Southern Highlands. That driving rain and wind will allow totals to mount up here, and notice that these areas are mainly high ground as well. It does start off on a quiet note, but there will be some possible disruption due to Storm Agnes and also potential close flooding. A largely dry start initially, even some early sunshine, then we'll start to see cloud gathering and the first signs of that rain pushing in here as we head through tomorrow afternoon, accompanied by a strong to gale force winds as well. So that leads us into a wet and windy afternoon for the southwest. Again, we could see those winds knocking into the severe category at times. Strong winds across the mainland, along with that rain gusting it up to gale force at times. The very far north and the Northern Isles getting really scot-free, dry with some sunny spells, but that rain will make inroads here as we head into tomorrow evening. So a spell of wet and windy weather for all tomorrow evening. Although in saying that, with the low pressure system banked right across us tomorrow night, there'll be a lull in the winds for the mainland. The strongest of winds will be down towards the southwest and also across the Northern Isles. Still those winds picking up as we head through the overnight period. So spell of wet and windy weather to end the day, end the night, I should say. Starting off windy on Thursday, the rain clearing away. We'll see some sunshine first thing and then blustery showers following on from the west. The wind's easing just a touch. That's your forecast.
Okay, thank you, Dylan.